Hello students, today we'll start with the topic megasporogenesis and megagametogenesis. What is megasporogenesis? It is the formation of megaspore from megaspore mother cell. Formation of megaspore, which is haploid, from megaspore mother cell, which is diploid, through meiosis. So megasporogenesis is the formation of megaspore from megaspore mother cell, and the formation of gamete from the megaspore is known as gametogenesis, megagametogenesis. Formation of gamete from megaspore is known as megagametogenesis. So megaspore mother cell, which is diploid in nature, undergoes meiosis to form megaspore, which is haploid. Four megaspores will be formed. Out of these four megaspores, three will degenerate and one will remain. This type of development, this type of process is known as monosporic development. This is known as monosporic development because further development takes place only in one megaspore, remaining three megaspores degenerate. Formation of megaspore is known as megasporogenesis. Then this megaspore, after development, it will form embryo sac or female gametophyte. After development, this megaspore will form female gametophyte, and inside this female gametophyte, egg gamete or megagamete is formed. Inside this gametophyte, that is embryo sac, egg will be formed, and the process of formation of egg is known as megagametogenesis. See, here in this whole diagram, I have shown monosporic development. This is megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell will undergo meiosis 1, in which karyokinesis is immediately followed by cytokinesis, and two haploid cells will be formed. Megaspore mother cell will undergo meiosis 1 to form two haploid cells. Then meiosis 2 will occur and 4 haploid cells will be formed. Out of these 4 haploid cells, 3 will degenerate. 3 will degenerate. See, these are 4 haploid cells. They are lying one beside each other. This type of arrangement is known as linear arrangement, linear tetrad. Out of this linear tetrad, 3 will degenerate and 1 will remain. 3 microspore at micropylar end. The three microspores which are at micropylar end will degenerate, and the microspore megaspore which is at the chelazal end will remain. This type of development is known as polygonum type. Now, this remaining megaspore will undergo mitosis, but this mitosis will be different from normal mitosis. This is free nuclear division. In this, the remaining megaspore will undergo free nuclear division, that is, nucleus will divide but the cytoplasm will not divide. So the nucleus of the cell will divide to form two nuclei. Again mitosis will take place. These two nuclei will form four nuclei. Again mitosis will take place and eight nuclei will be formed. So this megaspore will undergo three mitotic division or three free nuclear division to form eight nuclei, but the cell will be one only. One nuclei from each end. See, this is micropylar end and this is chelazal end. One nuclei from each end will move to the center. Will move to the center and they will form polar nuclei. They will form polar nuclei because they are coming from each pole. Three nuclei will be here and three nuclei will be here. Cell wall will be laid around each of these three nuclei. The three cells formed towards the micropylar end will form the egg apparatus. They will form the egg apparatus, and three cells towards the chelazal end, they are known as antipodal cells. These are known as antipodal cell. This arrangement is called 3 plus 2 plus 3 arrangement. This arrangement is called 3 plus 2 plus 3 arrangement. these three cells, which are the part of the egg apparatus, out of these three cells, cell number one is egg. It is also known as female gamete. It is egg or ovum. Cell number two or three are synergids. These are the synergids. Synergids are also known as helper cells or cooperative cells. These three are antipodal cell. The exact function of antipodal cell is not known, and they will degenerate soon. And this is polar nuclei. No cell wall is present around the polar nuclei. So, for formation of one female gametophyte, this is the whole structure of embryo sac, female gametophyte. Inside female gametophyte, one egg is present. Therefore, for formation of one female gametophyte, one meiosis and three mitosis are needed. So, I repeat the process. This is one megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell will undergo meiosis 1 to form 2 haploid cells, meiosis 2 to form 4 haploid cells. These 4 haploid cells are called megaspores or megaspore tetrad, linear tetrad. Out of these 4 megaspores, the 3 megaspores towards the micropylar end will get degenerated, and only the megaspore which is towards the chelazal end will remain. This megaspore will undergo 3 mitosis, which will be free nuclear division. That is 8 nuclei and 1 cell will be formed. These 8 nuclei will arrange themselves in such a manner that 3 towards each pole and 2 nuclei in the center. 3 nuclei towards the micropylar end are egg apparatus. They will form cell wall around it. Each nuclei will form cell wall around it, and they will form egg apparatus. And 3 cells towards the chelazal end will form the antipodal cell. The 2 nuclei which are in the center are polar nuclei. No cell wall is laid around the polar nuclei. They are known as polar nuclei because each nuclei has come from opposite poles. So, egg apparatus has one egg, 2 and 3 synergids, 4, 5, 6 are antipodal cells, 7th cell, this whole cell remaining is central cell. This central cell has 2 polar nuclei. 7 cells but 8 nuclei. So there are total 7 cells and 8 nuclei. This is the structure of female gametophyte or embryo sac. Now we will discuss the function of each of the cell of embryo sac. See, these are synergids. These cells are synergid. In between the synergids is egg cell. Synergids are vacuolated. They are having vacuoles towards the chelazal end. They have finger-like projection, which is known as filiform apparatus. This I have shown filiform apparatus. So synergids are also known as help cells. They are also known as cooperative cells. Their cytoplasm shows polarity. Polarity means at micropylar end, filiform apparatus is present or nucleus is present. Towards the chelazal end, vacuole is present. They show polarity at micropylar end in synergids, nucleus is present, see, and at chelazal end, vacuole is present. At micropylar end, finger-like projections represent filiform apparatus. Synergids are short-lived. They are not very long-lived. They are short-lived.